Hey everyone, my name is Julia, and today I'm going to show you how to use Clang Tidy in Visual Studio Code. Clang Tidy is a C++ linter tool. It provides an extensible framework for diagnosing and fixing typical programming errors, things like style violations, interface misuse, or bugs that can be deduced via static analysis. There are a bunch of different C++ linters out there. And one reason that people use Clang Tidy is because it can be run on any platform, Windows, Mac, or Linux. And while both Visual Studio and VS Code have Clang Tidy integration, Clang Tidy can also be run from the command line. This is great because this means that if you and your coworkers are using different editors or IDEs, you can all still integrate Clang Tidy into your C++ development workflow, achieving consistent linting across each of your environments. Let me show you how to use Clang Tidy in VS Code. In case some of you watching aren't familiar with how Clang Tidy works, I'll start by using the command line syntax in the terminal. To run Clang Tidy on your file, use the Clang Tidy command, followed by the name of the source file that you want to run Clang Tidy on, and then the dash checks flag to specify which Clang Tidy linter checks you want to run on this file. So I'm going to use the CPP core guidelines checks, and I'm going to add dash star, which indicates that I want to run all of the CPP core guidelines Clang Tidy checks on this file. And then I'll hit enter. All right, so I see that I have a warning from Clang Tidy, and it's telling me that 100 is a magic number. Consider replacing it with a named constant. And then it tells me which CPP core guidelines check this warning is coming from, and it's the avoid magic numbers check. In my code, I have 100 used here on line 20. I'm setting the count equal to 100. Now, let's say I do want to check for magic numbers in my code. Like, I don't want to disable that check, I want to keep it, but I want to allow the number 100 because I know that I want to use it and I don't want to deal with seeing warnings every single time I use it in my program. You can customize the Clang Tidy checks that you run by creating a .clangtidy configuration file in your workspace. So let's go ahead and do that. It's just called .clang-tidy. And then here, you can specify which checks you want to run along with check options to customize these checks. So a .clangtidy configuration file is really helpful if you want to, run multiple checks, but you don't want to have to type out all of them on the command line each time you want to run the linter on your code, or if you want to customize your checks, which is what we're doing, by setting the magic number 100 as an allowed number in our program. So if I save this file, and then let's run Clang Tidy again. But this time, I'm not going to use that checks flag. Clang Tidy will detect the .clangtidy configuration file in my workspace, and it will automatically use that. So let's see if we still get that warning for the number 100. Okay, so now I have a new warning, which is that one is also a magic number, but it's not flagging 100. It's letting that go through. So that means that Clang Tidy is, in fact, reading from our configuration file and allowing the number 100 to not be flagged as a warning. Now I'm going to show you how to run Clang Tidy in Visual Studio Code, not through the command line syntax. So there are two ways to run code analysis in VS Code. The first is to manually invoke code analysis by opening the command palette, which you can do by pressing Control Shift P, and then select Run Code Analysis on Active File. And this will run Clang Tidy. And VS Code detected the .clangtidy configuration file in my workspace. So it knows which checks and check options to use when running Clang Tidy on my active file, which is why I see a squiggle under the number one, and I get the same error message that I saw in the terminal that one is a magic number, consider replacing it with a named constant. And I can also see which check is causing this warning, and it's a hyperlink. So if you click on the name of that check, you'll be taken to the official documentation to learn more about what that check does and how you can customize it. I'm not seeing squiggles for the number 100 because VS Code is reading from our check options in the .clangtidy configuration file. So let's say you didn't have a clangtidy configuration file in your workspace. You can use VS Code's UI to enable and disable clangtidy checks. So if we open our VS Code settings for your workspace and then type code analysis, and then select C++, this is where you'll see all of the settings related to clangtidy. If we scroll down a bit, we see these two settings, one for checks disabled and one for checks enabled. So as I mentioned, you don't need to have a clangtidy configuration file in your workspace in order to use clangtidy with VS Code. You can just enable and disable checks in this UI. But if you do have a clangtidy configuration file, any checks that are enabled or disabled in this settings UI will be augmented to the clangtidy configuration file. So let's say I disable the magic numbers check in this UI. CBP core guidelines, avoid magic numbers. And another setting that I want to change is run automatically. So previously when I invoked clangtidy, I opened the command palette and manually run code analysis on active file. If you enable the run automatically setting, then code analysis will automatically be run anytime you open or save a file. So let's test that out. So now I'm going to save this file. VS Code should automatically be running clangtidy on my file right now. And the squiggle should not appear because I disabled that check. Now let's add some bad code to this program. I'm going to add a new variable x, and I'm not going to initialize it. So now when I save my file, code analysis should automatically run because I enabled the run automatically code analysis setting for the workspace. And I should see a squiggle under int x because it's not initialized, and I should not see a squiggle under the number 1 because I disabled the magic numbers check. And there is that squiggle. And if I hover over it, I can see what the warning is. You can also see the results of clangtidy checks in the problems pane. And something I did before this demo that you probably would want to do if your project has a lot of headers that you don't want to run code analysis on, is I updated the code analysis exclude setting in my settings.json file. So the code analysis exclude setting can be found in your workspace settings UI. And it basically allows you to specify a directory or a file name, or a list of files that you don't want to run clangtidy on when you are running clangtidy on your workspace. So if we look at my settings.json file, right here I specified the out directory as a directory that I don't want to include in my clangtidy code analysis. And that's because I have a bunch of headers in that directory that are third-party library headers. They're not things that I wrote, so I don't want to run my linter checks on all of those files. So if I hover over this variable, there's this item here that says quick fix. Outside of VS Code, clangtidy allows you to automatically apply suggested fixes from the checks that you ran on your code. That is not currently supported in VS Code, but it is something we are actively working on, and it's coming soon. So right now, if you click on Quick Fix, it'll give you the option to clear the code analysis squiggles if you just don't want to see them. Keep an eye out for upcoming releases where we'll allow you to automatically apply suggested fixes from clangtidy checks in the editor. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned about how to use Clang Tidy both from the command line and in VS Code. Please reach out on Twitter if you have any questions, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the Pure Virtual C++ conference.